My name is Kenny Salwey, and I'm known as the last river rat. Folks say I'm a dying breed. My home has always been the Mississippi River, and here I've survived all my life as a hunter, trapper, fisherman, and writer. The river is my lifeblood, and indeed it is the lifeblood of our nation. It splits America in half, so to speak, and yet it joins it together. The river is a nursery of life, a place that has intrigued me, a mysterious, magical place. A place where every season has a different story to tell. The upper Mississippi River backwaters have always been my home, and in particular a place called Big Lake Shack, which I built with my own two hands and my sweat. It stands a stone's throw from the water's edge. During all these years, I have gained a knowledge and a respect and a love for this place. All of the things that hang in the shack have a memory attached to them. I've never fit into what folks call the real world. But then I like to think that this is the real world here in the Mississippi backwaters. For nature is always real. Henry David Thoreau, one of America's first and foremost nature writers, once said that most of the glowing reports about winter are written beside the wood-burning stove. How true that is. For a river rat like me, this is the harshest, toughest time of the year. And all the critters and birds are struggling for survival. It is a time of silence, of rest. And for the weak, it is a time of death. Now is the time of the year when the white winds of winter roar down from Canada. The great river is frozen. Life becomes very hard for those that must hunt and eat every day. And it is especially hard for America's symbol, the magnificent bald eagle. The bald eagle is awe-inspiring. When you see it soar, the eagle soar from the bluff tops on the homeless wind. And hear its wing. See the strength, the dignity, the beauty of this bird. It is indeed a symbol of freedom. I would like to be an eagle. I would like to see what the eagle sees.
When one considers that an eagle is moving at close to 100 miles an hour in its power dive, and the fish is moving as well with the current, the eagle times that dive in order to hit its prey, a feat that is incomparable. The eagle lives along the upper Mississippi River in great numbers. Sometimes as many as 800 eagles can be seen on just one stretch of the river. Competing for gizzard shad and other fish. Us folks that have made a living along the Great River have always been called river rats. The name conjures up images of a besodden, muddy critter. And indeed, it's a nickname that comes from an icon of the Mississippi, the muskrat. I owe it much. I've eaten its meat and traded its fur. It's tenacious. It clings to life. Strengths that make me proud to be named after this courageous critter. The term river rat is not given to a person, it is earned. A river rat makes a living with the Mississippi River. I say with rather than off the river, because to live with something is to live in harmony. To live off of something is like a parasite, a bloodsucker, a louse, a wood tick. There's an old-time saying that river rats are too stubborn to freeze to death, too full of hot air to drown, and too damn independent to call anyone boss. I guess there's some truth in these words for one who's led a solitary life, surviving on whatever I could find along the river. I don't know if there's a pleasure in fishing or hunting or any consumptive use of wild critters. There's a gratification in the fact that I can secure my own food, and I don't have to hire a mercenary to do my killing for me, my butcher. In the winter time, the snapping turtle returns to its wintering grounds beneath the ice, down into that black, boot-sucking Mississippi mud. I harvest one. Let's face it, I kill.